This is Spoken Gospel. We're dedicated to seeing Jesus in all of Scripture. In each episode, we see what's happening in a biblical text and how it sheds light on Jesus and his gospel. Let's jump in. In Psalm 103, the psalmist, King David, commands both his soul and the nation he leads to celebrate God's compassion towards them. David first addresses his soul. He reminds himself of all the ways God has been compassionate to him. God has not only forgiven his sins, healed his diseases, and rescued him from certain death, if that wasn't enough, but he showered him with love. He's satisfied all his desires, and he's given him strength when he felt weak. God has been consistently compassionate to David. So he tells himself to praise his soul's guardian and provider. David then addresses his nation. As a nation, they have experienced and enjoyed God's compassion throughout their entire history. God's compassion moved him to liberate them from Egyptian slavery. When God's people responded to that compassion with nothing but rebellion and hatred, God did not treat them as their rebellion deserved. Instead, moved by compassion, he told them he is a God who is slow to anger and will abound in that compassion towards them. He forgave their forefathers for their rebellion and wiped their sins clean off the map. Like a patient father, God's compassionate love dealt gently with his disobedient children. David then declares that God's compassion will extend eternally into his people's future. Since God lives forever, so must his love for his people. David then ends his song by commanding the angels to join his nation in celebrating their endlessly compassionate God. Like David, we should remind ourselves and the people around us of God's remarkable compassion. Our way to do this is to remind ourselves of all the ways God has protected and provided for us in his love. But God's ultimate act of compassion was demonstrated when God sent Jesus to forgive undeserving people like us. When we look at Jesus, we see God's compassion towards his people. Jesus' earthly ministry was marked by forgiving sins, healing diseases, and raising people from the dead. But just like their forefathers, the people of Jesus' day hated and rebelled against his displays of compassion and forgiveness. But Jesus was so slow to anger that he refused to defend himself, and he allowed these people to torture and kill him. Abounding in compassion, he even asked God to forgive his executioners as they nailed his hands and feet to a cross. But in his death, Jesus was doing more than simply being slow to anger. Jesus was dying as rebels deserved, so that rebels like us could live as if their sins had been completely wiped off the map. Jesus then rose from the dead to show God's compassion extends beyond the grave. And since Jesus now lives forever, God's loving compassion towards his people never ends either. We have all done things that have disqualified us from God's love. But we can still sing Psalm 103 to our souls, because in Jesus, God does not treat us as our sins deserve. Because of Jesus, we are children of God who have been swallowed up in our patient Father's never-ending compassion and love. So I pray that the Holy Spirit would open your eyes to see the God who does not treat us as our sins deserve. And may you see Jesus as the one who died and rose to show God's loving compassion that never runs out for his children.